really should start this conference off by congratulating Elvis, because we will have two new firsts. The first new first involves Elvis as the first performer to do a worldwide live concert via satellite. A real spectacular. And the second is that we will have a worldwide album via satellite. All of this has been made possible by the joint efforts of a lot of people, and especially including Colonel Tom Parker. Elvis, again, my congratulations for this spectacular.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. It's very hard to comprehend it, because in 15 years, it's hard to comprehend that happening, you know.
To all the
countries all over the world via satellite. It's very difficult to comprehend. A live concert, to me, is exciting because of all the electricity that's generated in the crowd and on stage. But it's my favorite part of the business, is a live concert.
How do you pace yourself?
Sir?
How do you pace yourself?
You mean physically, vocally, or whatever?
So you are up when you need to be up?
I just, I exercise every day. I vocalize every day. I practice if I'm working or not. No. So I just try to stay in shape all the time. Vocally and mentally.
Which is harder?
Well, both are tough, yeah. You got to work at them, but I don't mind it, you know. It's worth it. Well, now they shoot me all the way, see? So just the waist down. Now, but I would like to think that I had improved as an entertainer. And I'd like to get the rapport with an audience, because it's a give and take thing. If you can do that, it works, you know. If the artist or whoever is performing can get that kind of rapport going with the audience, then it really pays off. It's good, you know.
But do you feel that you have more of that rapport now than you did 15 years ago?
I couldn't answer that. I really couldn't.
I must say this about the, when we first approached the various countries around the world, Elvis is certainly the only performer that could do this today. He is well known in every country that we have toured, in fact, in every country in the world, and the acceptance was just fantastic. It wasn't a case of any selling, because, you know, he's been in demand for live performances around the world, but you just can't do this, so this is the way of approaching it. But the acceptance exceeded all of our expectations, Elvis.
Thank you very much. That's very nice.
Got an interesting call from the head of specials at NBC, John Hamlin. Called me and said, would you like to be interested in doing the very first satellite show in Elvis television? I said, you know my answer. I said, well, I can't say, you have art, okay. We would like to have you do it, you produce and direct it. I said, fine. But you need to have the stars okay. I said, okay. Who is it? Wouldn't tell me. So you got to go look. He's performing on stage. Oh, really? Okay, you got to go see him. So, you know, my wife and I would say, okay, we'll go see him. We went there, and who came out on stage? Elvis Presley. You've got to go and talk to the Colonel, Colonel Parker in Vegas. Get his okay and get Elvis's okay before you can do this show. I ended up with Colonel Hilton in the lobby, and I said, I would like to have him lower in the stage. And so he says, no, my guards are there. I have guards there, security guards. They're going to be there next to the stage. And I said, I want a runway there, and I want to have all girls there with lays and stuff like that. And no, I don't want him anywhere near the people. And I said, but he can be in the center. And that if he doesn't want to be near them, he walks down the center, they can't reach him. If he wants to get it with them, he walks over to them, they can get to him. It's his call. And he says, no, I will not have that. And I don't want all that lights. It's taking away from my boy, my star. And he said, no, I won't accept any of it. I says, listen, I've come all this way, and I'm going to at least meet with Elvis. He says, because I'm not going to go back unless I meet with him. He says, well, no, he's not going to do it. He won't do it. I mean, will you please call up there? So he sent two goons down. These goons became buddies of mine, so they don't mind. They left. And so they sat there, and I said, there's an empty chair. And I went, I just waited. I was getting nervous. I was really nervous. I didn't know what to do. Because I said, this is the first satellite show. I don't want to do this. I want to be able to try to do this. But I got to get my foot in the door. And so Elvis comes in. He had shades this big, a big feathered hat and a big coat on. And came in and sat down, didn't say a word. Like that, and sat down. I says, oh my God, I'm old. Well, here goes the rope. Here I go. I started to look at the guy, and I said, Elvis, hi, I'm Marty Pasetta. NBC has asked me to, with your approval, to produce and direct this show. The first satellite show. You're going to be seen by millions of people. Here I am to talk creatively with you to see if you agree with me. And still no reaction from anybody. And I said, I went to see you for NBC's request in Santa Monica. I saw you on stage, and you stood there and you did a performance. Your music is outstanding. But let me tell you something. You weren't exciting. It was boring, and I don't know what I'm going to do with you for an hour and a half, but I have an idea. At that time, he sat up stiff. And as I was taking out the drawing, the two guys took out silver-plated guns and put them on the table. And if you don't think I was inhibited, you're crazy. Because I was shaking in my boots.
If you come down to the river,
I opened up the drawing and showed Elvis. I said, Elvis, here's what I want to do. I want to do this because here, it's going to be exciting. It's never been done. It's your name and all the different languages that's going to be seeing this show. They're going to know who you are because it's up there. And I have this runway. You can come down the center or you can go over to the girls and so forth. And I want those girls to relate to you and you relate to the girls. That's where the magic is going to be. And you look great up there and you've got to lose weight. And he jumped up. And I said, if you did all this, we're going to have a good show. He jumped up, threw his hat away, took the glasses off, and left his coat, ran over to me, grabbed me, hugged me. And he says, you're the first person that's been honest with me. And he says, I would lose weight. He lost 25 pounds. And I called an art director friend of mine, Ray Clausen. He says, Ray, here's what I have in mind. Let's take his name, the name Elvis, and make it in all the different fonts of the world, Chinese and Arabic and everything, and we do it as Elvis all over the place, and so that in neons and light bulbs and everything, so it's alive, it lives. And I said, I'd like some mirrors in there so that we bring the audience that is not on the stage, but if I take a cross shot, it looks like the audience is on the other side of him. And to make him comfortable with an audience involved, even when he's on the middle of the stage.
All I gotta do,
the making of the show was very interesting because we built the scenery over in Hawaii and we did all the electronics in the NBC shops here and brought it over there. All my crew were from here. We brought over the little truck that I had used in compact video to do some remote stuff. And I put Don Ho in a tree and put things. And we did some stuff. And when Elvis' arrival, which we stayed, coming in via helicopter.
Elvis is now stepping out of the helicopter. He's attired in a white suit.
We had a lot of good radio contacts over there. because we had to fill this auditorium. And it was a big, big, big civic auditorium.
He's coming up to get laves from the crowd. Hey, Elvis, how are you?
I'm all right.
Good to see you. Welcome back.
Thank you. Nice to see you.
You look
glad
great.
To be back. Thank
Happy
you very
birthday,
much.
Happy birthday, one day late.
Thank you very much.
Nice reception, huh?
Yeah, very, very nice. Yeah.
How long you be in town this time, is it?
About a week, I would imagine, Tom.
It's going to be a big show Saturday.
Oh, it's Sunday morning. It's got to be, I hope it's good, you know.
I'm sure it will be.
I'm going to do my best.
Elvis, you got a lot of people here wanting to give you lays and say hello to you.
Okay, fantastic.
It's the biggest one since Alaska.
It's the biggest thing I've ever done.
Yeah,
Tom.
Yeah. Okay, thanks, Elvis.
Appreciate it.
And that was Elvis Presley as he arrived here before hundreds and hundreds of people. Who are now.
There was a love affair, and we got to capture that.
It's really wild.
I have a lot of cameramen. I can't remember a lot of the names. But they did my Crosby show. They did the Oscars. Because we knew each other. And, you know, and then if we needed more, I'd bring another two or people in. Now it's mostly freelance. And I started to, when it was not the networks doing the big show, you start to learn your freelance crews. And they're still out there doing that. And I know the right ones to call because we think alike and we can understand that you don't have to start teaching people what a zoom is, what a pan, a tilt left, and you know, focus right and focus in. And these are terminologies that you and your crew is simpatico, and it's an extension of you, and that helps you and you help them because you think alike.
What an ugly bugger that guy, huh? Really? What the cheap blood? I don't know. Really, I'm better looking than him, huh?
And I told Elvis about the colonel saying no, and he says, don't worry about it. He does the business side, I am the creative side. And I found out that they really didn't have much communications between the two of them. It went through Joe Esposito. Elvis would talk to Joe then would tell the colonel, and vice versa. That's how it happened. But anything creative, it was between Elvis and myself. And he loved it. He loved everything. He would work on the music and what he wanted to do musically. And then everything else was me. I brought with all my crew, we brought the truck over on a big, big boat because there was no color stuff in Hawaii. Just before we did the show, my PA said, oh my God, we are 10 minutes short. I said, excuse me? This is a hell of a time to tell me we're 10 minutes short. We're supposed to go out live to the world. And I went running out the door. I said, oh, I gotta get to Elvis. I went out the door. I'm running down the stairs, went to the backstage. The guard saw me. They opened the door. They know where I was going. The guard's at the door, his dressing room. They opened the door. Elvis, Marty, what's going on? I said, Elvis, we're short by 10 minutes. He said, okay, do this, this, and this. And where are we gonna do it? There, done. Let's go. See you. We did it. The show, when it was seen, finally, the first time it was seen around the world, it was seen by every third person on Earth. Even the Oscars, nothing has topped that. No, the Super Bowl, nothing has ever topped the ratings of that show the first time. The dialogue, everything the dialogue was Elvis. There's no cue card, nothing on that show. He did it. And he gave me a nice tribute. Live, unbeknownst to me. It was very, very nice.
I'd like to thank our producer and director, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Marty Pasetta, for putting this show together. He's really done a fantastic job, him and his staff. And there's been a lot of people working on the show. As you know, we're going out live. And we were doing it for the Cooley Cancer Drive. We were supposed to raise $25,000, and we raised $75,000 tonight. So thank you.
Cooley was a very, very good friend of Elvis. He wrote some, a lot of music, and really special, special, special guy.
I'll remember you long after this, in the summer is gone. I'll be lonely, oh so lonely, living only to remember you. I'll remember too.
When we finished the show and we went on the runway after the place was empty, we had to do six more songs for the U.S. because we had to do a longer version for over here. And we did it with Black, and I did a lot of remotes and stuff. We got into multiple, the windows, I took that over there that we did from the Oscars on NBC. So I took that package over, and we hooked it up around the floor and in the truck.
We'll try to save it this time.
Oh, shit.
Other people that came in, and those people that came in, were from a little company that started up called Grass Valley. Grass Valley Switchers now put that in from our show.
You know, if you can't hack it, Charlie's ready.
Shit, you can't hack it either.
I will remember to
everybody. When we finished the show, the live show, he went running off the stage, and he went over and he saw my wife over the sides. He got a beeline to her, and he hugged her. He went running over there. Everybody said, "What the hell is that?" And he hugged her. This is a great experience. Best thing I've done. We became lasting friends till the day he died.
I remember you in the land of cotton. Old times are not forgotten. Look away, Dixieland.
Sing it, fellas. Dixieland, I was born. Early Lord, one frosty morn. Look away, Dixieland.
Glory, hallelujah. So hush, little baby, don't you cry. You know your daddy's bound to die. But all my trials, Lord, soon